Wait! I am not going to face down the game's final boss without hard saving my game. Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. I am out of here, and in case you didn't realize in the last part, I forgot to go back in the bonus area at Animal Antics, you know, the one just before the squawk section, to recollect the Donkey Kong coin, hero coin, whatever you want to call it, because, you know, I game over and it didn't save my coin, so there you go, I got the coin off camera. You already seen me get it on camera, you know I can do it off camera. Anyway, Krocodile Core, let's start. Well, it looks like he survived, and I should probably be Diddy for this fight to start out with. And he's as good as new. This battle is pretty much like an endurance test for the most part, because you only have to hit him once through the entire fight, and I call this a fight very loosely here, because it's rather one-sided in his part, in that it is a dodging game of sorts until you get your opportunity to be able to hit him. And you'll get the hang of all these patterns. Oh shit! I thought he was gonna switch off. Oh no! I thought he was gonna switch off to the one where he shoots one and then shoots a faster one like that. But that was a wrong pattern that I was thinking of, and I anticipated the wrong pattern, and because of it, I took a hit. But I'm talking about a hit that I took way far ago. So I'm talking about the past. It's kind of pointless to talk about the past. So yeah, let's just focus on what's coming at me right now. Duck under this one. Or you can jump over it as well, but it's not recommended. There we go. Yeah! There's the last Donkey Kong coin! And he's in the core. Oh jeez. Well, there goes the island. Abandon island! Stop being so casual, Dixie, we're all gonna die! Well, thanks, but you didn't really have much faith in me, did you? And hurry, stop talking, just go! Take Funky's flights out of here! And there we go, first place, baby! Well, there wasn't really any competition in all honesty, it's just a collection screen of sorts. You're not afraid to admit it, even if you're wrong occasionally, really now. Thank you, I am bowing but you can't see me. Well, I think he might be done for, except for that bolt over there, which may indicate that he's leaving. Yeah, he's leaving. He's safe. He made it. Dang it. Well, I guess there's only one thing left to do. They gotta make a sequel, don't they? Yup. And I think we're pretty much just stuck on this screen until we press a button. But there are extras to do, so it's bonus time! Starting with all of the dialogue that I didn't buy so far from Monkey Museum and Kong College in Every World. So yes, I will test your amazing knowledge, even though I have a feeling that this is going to end up being more awkward than anything, because I'm just going to be like, interesting the whole time. interesting. Yeah, I see. I mean, I'm sure you see what I mean here, but I'm pretty sure I have enough coins to buy all this stuff, because there's only a few worlds and only a few things to buy in each world. So yeah, now Kong College, and this is basically what I'm gonna be doing here, is just going through the worlds in order here with all the stuff that I didn't buy just yet. And yeah, I've already taught stuff like this through the walkthrough, but I figured you might be interested in hearing what they would say, like, if you didn't hear it from me, basically, and you heard it from the game. Yeah, that was I think that would be way too easy to figure out even for... maybe not. I was gonna say for a new player, but I don't know, because it's like a classic turn enemies attack against them sort of thing that kind of reminds me of something that anyone would think of. That's why I would say a beginner. Anyway, Crocodile Cauldron, did that. Oops, what am I doing? Kong College. And it's pretty nice that I have, like, you know, all the stuff that I didn't buy here. It's kind of like they automatically are marked for me, you know, the ones, it's like a checklist of sorts, other than, you know, saving your game and whatnot. Because, you know, once you save your game, then it turns to 2 coins, and yeah, I already covered that earlier on. Yep, definitely taught that by now. What do you mean, before he gets angry? He is angry as soon as you hit him. I will take care, but perhaps you should go to the doctor. Because I don't think you're paying much attention here. Cranky is rather knowledgeable, but he doesn't have very much confidence in us. yeah, I definitely got that. Yeah, I definitely got that. And, interesting. Yeah, I just had to reference the beginning there. You already seen me get 99 coins earlier on in the walkthrough, so I don't really have to bother showing that. But I did max out my life counter just for the fun of it. What am I doing here? I need to go to Funky Flights. But yeah, I thought I would show you that it doesn't go up over 99 lives. Just a little bit later on, Kong College. Oh, repeats once again. At least super jump. Yeah, the game even sort of teaches you that as you go, because, you know, in the first level that you have Radley, it teaches you to use the A button at certain spots, and, well, yeah, so I don't really know. Well, I suppose this occurs before the level, I think. Wait, did that say... Oh, see, they are called Hero Coins. Huh, so they're not... Well, maybe they're called both. Like, maybe some call them Donkey Kong coins, some call them DK coins, others call them Hero coins. But yeah, they're indeed. I mean, another name for them is indeed Hero coins. So that's my memory wasn't that bad after all. And I definitely taught that. I know you will be. Oh, and once you buy a tip, obviously you can. Use the tip again if you would like, you know, to recheck it for free. Limmer's Galleon? Now, you're saying don't let it get you down, like, yeah, it's hinting to go down somewhere, I guess. Right, that's a pretty vague hint, if you ask me. I already definitely showed that. Because I had to get the bonus area there. Funky Flights 2. Next level of dialogue. Going up, Crazy Kremlin. I can go right to Kong College. This I will do. I'm pretty sure I'll have beaten him by the time I show this part of the video. yep, taught that during a couple of bonus segments. That would be rather handy, though, to teach people, because the air jump, you know, by cartwheeling off an edge like that is not something that's immediately obvious. That was not very many tips there that I didn't... have access to before. I should say I didn't check before. Cranky's kind of out of the way though. Oh shoot, I clicked through that. My mistake. Well, guess you're gonna have to pause at the perfect frame so you can read that. Since it's on camera, I'm sure you'll be able to see it, with a cleverly placed pause, if you care about it. It's probably just a repeat, in all honesty. I guess he's hinting at the bonus area that was in the wall before that barrel, and... yeah, that was those two bonus areas right at the start of Horned Hole. Funky Flights 2. Bloop! Gloomy Gulch. Monkey Museum. And I think this video is going to end up being more and more silent as I run out of stuff to say about the dialogue. That's kind of worrisome, in all honesty. That would have been a hint as to where the where a bonus area was, but I managed to find that. Kidoki. Now, was I to this Kong College before? I'm not. Come to think of it, I'm not sure about that. No, I definitely was, because otherwise saving my game would have been free. Okay. Only two things to buy here. Telling about the scoring of the game save file. Yeah. I already showed that. Two Funky Flights 2. Your plane is always tuned up. It's the most reliable plane in history. Well, they're right at the beginning here. Monkey Museum. Clapper's Cavern. It's up to you. Yeah, he's hinting at that with the up there. It only seems like he's not actually hinting to anything there, but it's something that you have to do at the start. Very clever riddles, I must say. Well, I guess they're not really riddles so much as they are hints, per se. No problem, even though, again, I'm pretty sure I already did that by now. When I edit this video. Kong College. Oh, I definitely am. Although, I have murdered a lot of crocodiles. Wow, only one thing to buy here, really? And that's pretty much the same as the Rambi one, too. Wow. Peeps are running out of things to say, too. Alright, there is just that. Oh, wait, I gotta go back to the Lost World, too. No Cranky's cabin up here. I guess it was too expensive for him to build a cabin up here. I mean, museum up here, excuse me. Cranky's cabin, or I think other games. Oh, hint how to beat the final boss, which I've already done. That is quite a hint there. And I do agree with that, so that you can get the hang of the boss. And, yeah, I gotta go back to the Lost World. Wait, actually, doesn't matter which Lost World I go to, really? I don't think so. Because I think the, Monkey Museum at, past here will be a, Alright, I didn't get the last coin from the final boss yet. My mistake. Darr, I guess it doesn't matter. Of course I would choose the one that I haven't paid for yet. So yeah, now you know when this part of the video was made. It's just that I'm doing this before I beat the final boss, because I'm pretty sure when I beat the final boss, my, and I just went to the wrong world, didn't I? Because there, oh my god, what's wrong with me? There's no Clubhouse kiosk here. Because once I beat the final boss, my coin count will be reset. Okay. Stop being stupid, PkGam. There you go. I knew you could do it. Alright. Just 5 tips to buy here at the Monkey Museum. All 2 apiece, so it will be 10. and I definitely have to take heed of the hint that I'll get for animal antics, because that is definitely not a level I want to play twice if I can help it. The end is not the end. That's actually kind of vague, but I'll keep that in mind. Alright, now to show you my life counter here. You are probably extremely rich now, Cranky. I have collected so many coins! Now I'm going to show you the maxed out life counter that I have here. So yeah, I maxed out both the coins and my lives here. So Pirate Panic, this is basically how I maxed out the lives with how many I had. See, 99 up there. I went in here. I grabbed the balloon. I start selected. That's basically all I did. Alright, now I'm going to show you some other stuff about this game. It's time for the cheats and secrets! Well, I admit I don't know all of the game's secrets and cheats and stuff like that, and it's rather hard to actually compile a list of them, because it seems like everything's scattered across the internet. But anyway, let's start by taking a new game here. Yeah, I deleted my test file a little while ago just so I could do this a little bit quicker. Now, when you're on this screen, before you even start the game, go all the way down to the bottom, press down 5 times. Behold, a music test! Yeah, I'm not really going through them. I mean, I'm not really letting you listen to them, but yeah, it's got the music test. You cycle through them with the D-pad, and there you go. But anyway, press down 5 more times, and you enter the cheat mode. There are various kinds of cheats that you can use here to make the game harder or easier, depending on what you want. So actually, I think there's only 2 cheats out there that I could find, so there's 2 cheats, I guess, maybe. Anyway, if you want to start the game with 50 lives, press Y, A, select, A, down, left, A, down. What? Did I screw up something? Hold on a sec. Y, A, select, A, down, left, A, down. Yeah, okay, something screwed up there my first time. Alright, for hard mode, if you want to play the game without any Donkey Kong barrels in it whatsoever, press B, A, right, right, and I pressed up. Ah, that's probably why, because my dang Xbox pad. Okay, let's try this again. B, A, right, right, A, left. I hate this pad so much. B, A, right, right, A, left, A, X. Thank you, game. Well, I should say thank you, controller. So, okay, now I'll be able to show you what that means. I'll start a new game here. Now, you'll notice that because you don't have Donkey Kong barrels in the levels, when you start a level, you will start out with both Kongs, but you will not be able to replenish any Kongs along the way, so you gotta make do with what you have throughout the entire level, and that's what makes it hard mode, basically. And since you need the team throw to get certain stuff in later parts of levels, it will drastically make 100%ing certain levels harder. Anyway, let's go to some other stuff. To show you the rest of this stuff, I'm gonna use my main save file here with exactly 5 hours of gameplay and 102% completion, which is the highest you can get. When you're on the map screen such as this, press LRR, LRR, LRR as fast as you can, and something will happen. There we go. It's just, you just repeat that pattern, L then 2 R's, L then 2 R's, and you'll be able to see the status screen for Cranky's Video Game Heroes. Why you would need to use this when you see it at the end of the game, I don't know, but it's there if you want it. There's another cheat code, which you can do all the way back at the very first level of the game here. This is, you can get all 75 creme coins, well, I should say get 75 creme coins at once if you follow these directions. Go in this cabin, do not collect the balloon over there, and leave. Do not collect those first two bananas, you know, these two right here, oh geez. See these two right in front? Do not collect them. Seriously, it's a special cheat code they programmed in this. And you dodge that. It doesn't matter if you kill these enemies or whatnot, just kill them if you would like to. Just then collect the bananas here, and go back over, and jump over the bananas, go back inside, collect the balloon. Now repeat collecting the bunch. Ugh, I'm scared. I mean, scared to do that Y button to hold the run. Now collect the bananas again and go back in the cabin again without collecting those two bananas. A special creme coin will appear that will give you 75 creme coins. Yeah, this actually exists in the game. Probably something for the programmers, like as a way for them to easily beta test the game without having to 102% the game every time they want to do so. Or maybe they just did this as an Easter egg of sorts. I don't know. Anyway, more secrets. In Gangplank Galley here, there is a little bitty secret. If you swap. Where can I swap characters? There we go. Swap to Dixie and go over here and jump over the barrel and do the helicopter spin above the bonus barrel. You will come to this exclamation point area, which warps you all the way to the end of the level. Why you would want to do this when you're 100%ing the game? You wouldn't. This is just something if you want to skip the whole level. But yeah, it takes you all the way to the end. There's a couple of levels in the game like that. Lockjaw's Locker is another level that has this sort of secret dealio thingy that lets you warp to the end of the level. First, you've got to raise the water level. And, well, I'm gonna get a buddy, but a buddy's not necessary for this. Let's go and get the water up. Now go back. Remember this trick to get those coins away at the start? Well, look in here. Oh, maybe it's not this. Oh, there it is. Secret hidden barrel. Another exclamation point room, which tells you... Yep, warps you all the way over to the end. Just another level shortcut that if you use, you're gonna miss all the bonuses and fun of the level itself. Over here at Squawks' Shaft, we got yet another sort of shortcut. This is the last one that I know of. There might be more in the game, I'm just showing you these for fun. Alright, over here, you'll notice that there is a banana coin, right? Well, if you go over here and... Yep! You see what I did there? I did a jump off the edge with a run twirl thing, whatever you want to call it, exclamation point area. And it takes you to the end, of course. Oh, there you go. And with that, that's all the secrets that I know of. So I think this walkthrough is concluded. I hope you enjoyed the ride, and I will see you in the next walkthrough.